We have our live-action Powerpuff Girls, the latest Star Trek series is now filming, and we've also got a bunch of casting news from DC Comics. It's the Nerd News Headlines for March 14th, 2021. Afternoon all, Mark Kapp is here with this week's installment of Nerd News Headlines. St. Patrick's Day is coming up this week, which is why I'm wearing my stylish green shirt. Last year, I realized that I'd never actually owned a green shirt for St. Patrick's Day, so I went out and bought one. I was a little worried that it wasn't going to fit because of my pandemic pounds, but hey, check it out! It still does! So I'm ready to go out and get hammered on green beer. Who am I kidding? Craziest I get on St. Patrick's Day is I hit the McDonald's drive-thru for a shamrock shake. But anyways, on with the show! Today in reboots that nobody asked for, we're getting a live-action Powerpuff Girls! In this live-action version, the girls are now jaded 20-somethings who have given up their crime-fighting careers, but are called back into action when new villains threaten... the City of Townsville! You just gotta say it like that. I loved the show back in the day. It premiered during my final year of college, and it was must-see TV down in the dorms. But I digress. They announced the cast this past week. So, who are our grown-up Powerpuff Girls? Blossom is going to be played by Chloe Bennett. Bennett is fresh off Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., where she played the Marvel superhero Quake. Our jaded 20-something Blossom is described as holding several advanced degrees, and her time as a child superhero has left her with PTSD and anxiety issues. These are the inner demons she'll have to face to once again become the leader of the Powerpuff Girls. Bubbles is going to be played by Dove Cameron. Cameron is best known for her work on the Disney Channel. She played Mal, the teenage daughter of Maleficent, in the Descendants franchise. As a youngster, Bubbles was the joy and the laughter of the group. Now as a grown-up, she still puts on that public face, but it hides, quote, an unexpected toughness and wit. They tell us that Bubbles originally starts crime-fighting again to once again recapture her former fame. And Buttercup is going to be played by Yana Peralt. Peralt is currently a Broadway star, starring in the Alanis Morissette musical Jagged Little Pill. While Buttercup was originally the toughest fighter of the group, she has spent her adulthood trying to shed her past life and live a life of anonymity. They've got some great talent behind the camera as well, developing the series as Heather Regnier and Diablo Cody. Regnier is a television veteran, having worked on Veronica Mars and Sleepy Hollow, and Cody won an Oscar for writing Juno. It'll be coming to the CW this fall. Now see, that right there is what's giving me pause. The CW also airs Riverdale, and I can't help but think that this live-action Powerpuff Girls is going to do to the girls what Riverdale did to the cast of Archie Comics. When it premieres this fall, I'm going to go into it just greatly expecting to cringe. Or who knows, it might wind up like that other gritty reboot I watched just for the cringe, Anne with an E, that reboot of Anne of Green Gables. It was cringe-tastic during its first season, but about halfway through the second, it became just another CBC period drama. So what will become of the Powerpuff Girls? Cringe-tastic or just another superhero show? Only time will tell. Steven Spielberg is getting his next film ready to go. The legendary filmmaker has reached that point in his career where he's thinking about writing his memoirs, and his next film will be a semi-autobiographical tale about his childhood. Michelle Williams has just signed on to play the character loosely based on his mother, and casting is underway for the kid. They hope to start filming this summer for release sometime next year. Spielberg himself will be co-writing the script, and this is the first time he's getting a writer's credit in 20 years. I kind of wonder how this is going to turn out because, quote, a semi-autobiographical tale about his childhood is how he described E.T. back in the day. Spielberg's latest film, a remake of West Side Story, should be out this Christmas. We've got a trio of fun tidbits coming down from the DC universe. Firstly, in the upcoming movie version of The Flash, Kiersey Clemons will be reprising her role of The Flash's one true love, Iris West. Clemons was originally in Justice League, but wound up on the cutting room floor when Joss Whedon did his edit. We'll finally be able to see her back in action as Iris when the Snyder Cut drops on Crave this Thursday. The Doom Patrol has their big bad for their third season. Michelle Gomez has joined the cast as the villainous Madame Rouge. In the comics, Madame Rouge is a master of disguise and a member of the Brotherhood of Evil. And of course, being a Doctor Who fan, I best know Gomez as Missy, the female regeneration of the Master. She's also been on The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina and The Flight Attendant. No word yet on when season 3 is going to start filming, so this is the perfect time to catch up on the first two seasons. I swear, Doom Patrol is the most messed up superhero show on TV, and I mean that in the best possible way. And we know what our first two straight-to-HBO Max DC films are going to be. You may remember back in the fall, Warner Brothers announced that as part of their plans for DC Comics, as many as 2 DC movies per year are going to go straight to their streaming service, HBO Max. Well, at their shareholders meeting this past week, they let slip that the first two will be Batgirl and Zatanna. DC's been trying to get a Batgirl movie off the ground since 2017, with Joss Whedon once being attached to write and direct. And then, of course, he left to go tinker with Justice League. We're getting more Star Trek shows than we can shake a stick at, and this week Paramount announced that the newest one, Star Trek Strange New Worlds, has begun filming. This series is going to take place about 10 years before the original series, and will follow the adventures of Captain Christopher Pike and his crew of the Starship Enterprise. Anson Mount is Captain Pike, Rebecca Romijn is Number One, and Ethan Peck is the young Spock. All of them are reprising their roles after being introduced on Season 2 of Star Trek Discovery. Joining them from left to right will be Babs Alusanmakan, Christina Chong, Jess Bush, Melissa Navia, and Celia Rose Gooding. No word yet on who all these folks will be playing. This is one of 6 Star Trek shows that are coming down the pike. We got Season 4 of Discovery, Season 2 of Picard, Season 2 of Lower Decks, the first season of Prodigy, and a Section 31 show. Like all Star Trek shows, it's being made for Paramount Plus, which means up here in Canada, it's gonna be on Crave. Michael B. Jordan is getting ready to make his directorial debut. The Creed and Black Panther star will be moving behind the camera to direct Creed 3. We still don't know what it's about or if any of the other cast members. Hell, we still don't even know if Sylvester Stallone will be back as Rocky. I still haven't seen any of the Creed movies. It's one of those ones where I've heard so many good things that I'm wondering why I haven't seen it yet. Creed 3 is slated to hit theaters in November of 2022. And we're ending things with some good news for James Cameron. Avatar has just beaten Avengers Endgame to once again become the number one movie of all time. See, movie theaters are once again reopened in China, and right now the number one movie in China, a re-release of Avatar. Avatar's worldwide box office gross is now at $2.8 billion. Never underestimate the drawing power of those giant blue cats. And that's all the news that caught my eye for this week that just ended. As always, thank you for tuning in. Like, share, and subscribe, as the kids say. Inspirational phrase to end the show on. That's the direction I have in my script. I was actually supposed to go back and add in an inspirational phrase, but I forgot to. Bye!